Hi, welcome back. Euro Truck Simulator 2, discovering Europe, discovering Lithuania. Last city, Lithuania. Jim Penavone, your driver, guide, whatever. Producer, director. Anyway, we have a cargo of ice lollies. Not a clue. I'll have to look it up. From, I think it's Ostroleka, Poland, to Panevezys, Lithuania. 9 hours and 30 minutes remaining in the contract. Standard earn 10,048 euros. I need to push that button. Excuse me. We'll be driving the Volvo FH Mark 1 Globetrotter XL, 420 horsepower, 2,000 newton meters of torque, and an I-Shift ATO 3512D. 12-speed. Probably no retarder. Is that... Oh... Yeah, it's at the bottom of the bike. Fine. Okay, here we are. And let's take... Whoops! Pushed the wrong button. There we go. Alright. Oops. Everything's oopsing all of a sudden here. Okay, let's get the cab. Boy, it's bright. Okay, set the parking brake and start the engine. All its little information's down there. That changes. Okay. Well, alright. That's kind of inconvenient, but we'll live with it. Alright. Let's put it in gear. Okay. Well, before we do anything else, let's look outside again. And... Okay, we just wanted to go. Can't go that way. Perth. Alright, back in the cab. Comfy? Yes, we are. On? Off. On? Off. On? Off. Off. Nothing on the dashboard to show you, but... All these trucks here. What is that? That's a Renault. That's a Renault. A Mercedes. Okay. All kinds of big things on trucks. trailer. Oh, not even out far enough to see the traffic yet. Okay, well, we're that far out. May as well keep going. Oh, that car is... Oh, ho. Get out of his way, hopefully. Sorry. Well, not really, but... Sorry. Boy, it's really light out here in this truck. I'm not seeing a light here. Oh, there it is. Okay. Let's just sneak up on it a little bit more. There we go. Okay, they're stopping on that side. Let a little bit of traffic through. That, and we're on our way. Well, that's a little different. Whoa, different truck stop than I've seen before. This game. He's still following us. Well, that's really bright. Is it bright out there? No. Bright in there. Set cruise control. Kind of funny, last construction site had this truck, the camel truck, with a backhoe on it. There's somebody over plowing there, getting there, harvesting. Ticket. One of the things I've said it before, the one of the things I kind of dislike about American and Euro Truck Simulator both is the idea is that if you have to rest, you have to pull into a designated rest area. I mean, as you're driving along, you're seeing trucks sitting alongside the road. And if there's places where you can turn off and get off the road, yeah, there's no return. this beauty. Well, like up here where the dirt's on the side of the road, feasibly you could park there for a few hours, take a short nap. But God, I can't even read the signs. Used to be a building across the street from where I work. It was like kind of like about the size of a double wide trailer, and it had a smoke shop on one side and a real estate office on the other, I think. Anyway, it was eventually torn, or the property was bought. And they were going to put a convenience store gas station there. And they tore down, burned down the building, gave the fire department their, donated the building to the fire department for, training. And they went in, they leveled the whole thing. And that has been several years ago, so I guess the proper permits or whatever were never obtained or attainable, I'm not sure. But now, well, not now because of the snow, but when the weather is nicer, that seems to become a overnight parking area for a lot of trucks. And I don't know if anybody has permission to do it, but they park their trucks there. And it's like, you know, it's like going to Walmart. Sometimes you go to, if you go to Walmart, you may see a mobile home out there. Motorhome. May see two or three motorhomes out in the parking lot. Walmart has a thing where it allows motorhomes, or motorhomes, camp trailer, trailers, and things like that, at least an overnight stay. In certain areas where there isn't a lot of population. No, do that. Absolutely no blue. In certain areas, it's not unusual to see trucks sitting off of the on the sides of the road. See them quite often going down to the Tri-Cities, sitting there at the way stations. Way stations aren't open. They're really not not a major way station because they don't have a lot of parking. Basically just get the guys weighed in and out. when I was in Mill Creek, the city council of Mill Creek, based on the objections of some people, semis would sometimes, there used to be a Ernst Home Center, Ernst Malmo, which is closer akin to Ace Hardware. And they shared a parking lot with like Albertsons and was it Rite Aid Drugs? And there was a McDonald's and a Sherry's restaurant. There was another little corner with some buildings and shops. And sometimes the truck would be there to make a delivery to Ernst. And they got there at 3 o'clock in the morning, and there wasn't anybody there to receive shipment until 6, 7. So they would just park in the parking lot and take a nap. And Mill Creek and their wisdom passed an ordinance that could park a semi for any reason other than unloading or loading within the city limits. So, you know, sometimes there might be two or three semis over there and the guys go into Sherry's to get something to eat. No, that wasn't allowed. You had to park outside the city limits if you wanted to do that. And one day I worked at the, I don't remember we had changed over to BP yet or not. We were at Exxon and then changed over to BP, which is now changed over to Union 76. Last that I knew. It may have changed again. But anyway, you know, people come in and they get their gas there. And there was a semi that earlier in the evening, you know, late at night, early in the morning, he had come very close to running out of fuel. And he was waiting for, we had diesel, and he was waiting for, well, we didn't have any gas cans. I had like gallon gas cans. It'd take him forever to get enough fuel on the truck to be able to move. So he was waiting for the Ernst to open. So he could get down there and get, whoops. At least get a 5-gallon gas can. Because he couldn't get, he did not think he had enough fuel to be able to get into our station. Because he couldn't turn straight in, he had to go down like two or three blocks, turn around and go around the block and come back around. What? So he was just sitting across the street waiting for the Ernst to open at, forgot what time they are, like 8 o'clock. And there was a customer coming to the store. And immediately he starts griping about the... starts complaining about that truck sitting up there. How long's he been sitting there? Oh, he's been sitting there for, oh, I don't know, a couple hours. And then he wanted to know why I didn't call the police. Phone and call the police, because by God, we're not going to have any of that here in this town. Extremely fast, but you gotta remember that we're doing kilometers. So we're only doing like 50 miles an hour. That's the kind of things you start finding on the pro mods and Russian map and stuff. There's skid marks going across the road. Sometimes the police are there, sometimes they aren't. Grassy field, you see four tires sticking up out of the grass. You know what? I don't think I checked. Yeah, I did. No, I didn't. Did I? We'll soon see. Minutes left to go. I'm thinking, I don't remember. Oh, I don't remember whether I, discoverables. I don't see any yet, but I don't see any. And the map is bad. I didn't. Panevezys discovered. Alright. Oh man, I'm gonna be really upset with myself if. Come on, come on, come on. Oh yeah, there's one there. Right there. And that's it. All right. Fine. I'm in the wrong lane. Oh, oh, oh. What's going on? Oh. That's crazy. I don't like that. Just looking around. That transition there. It's a little tiny Mercedes-Benz dealer. There's a truck sitting there, but they're not appropriate rest areas. Oh, Carnation, Nestle's. We used to go to Carnation Farms quite often for some reason when I was younger. Don't remember why. Remember, I used to go there, though. That was like I was, I don't know, somewhere between six and eight years old, I think. We used to get our milk from Carnation Farms when they used to deliver milk to your door. In glass bottles. And they used to have like a foil cover, and you tore the foil cover off, and there was a little paper paper cap, a little cardboard. Anyway, little cap. You used to lift that, pull that off, then you put that back on when you got done pouring your milk. And they used to do like what they did with the state quarters that we had here. Oh, what? Presidents of the United States, they had, oh, I don't remember what it was, but you, as they delivered when they did your home delivery, you get a card that had all the spots to put the milk caps. What they were called, and something else more recent has had milk caps, but they had collectible milk caps, and that's because there's a stupid glow on the truck. Oh, no, wait, that's reverse. Never mind. Okay. And you get it kind of a heavy, wasn't cardboard, more of a heavy construction paper that was printed, and it had what all the caps were. And let's go forward. Let's just clean it up a little bit. There. That's better. That's better. Alright, take it out of here. Take it out of here. Set the parking brake. I don't have to worry about that. We didn't turn it on. And just kind of compare. Anyway, in every every week or something like that, they had a new cap or a new line of caps or whatever. And they had different, they had the presidents, and they had something else and something else and something else. And I kept those until I was like 20 some odd years old. And I don't know, we finally threw them out because I had too much clutter. Still have too much clutter, but anyway. Job completed. Excellent. Ice lollies delivered from Ostroleka to Panevezys. Panevezys. 410 kilometers. Time taken 7 hours and 28 minutes. 152.5 liters of fuel. Made 10,048 euros and 532 experience points. Yes, we did lose a few hundred because people are negligently driving. Not our fault. Anyway, I thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed it, remember, thumbs up. Helps me out. Gets me noticed. In the YouTube world. Comments greatly appreciated. If you subscribe and check the little box every time I upload, you get a little email telling you what I've done. And speaking about doing things, that's it. We're done with Lithuania. that was the whole country. Three deliveries. So again, I thank you for watching. We'll be back in a new country next time. Not sure which one it is. I think it's Estonia. I may be wrong about that. But I hope you enjoyed it. And again, what can I say? I thank you very much. And that will be it for now.